This is Restoration Bible Church and Ministries. We are a people of excellence living purposefully. And now, here is God's servant, Reverend Tunde Bolanta, as he brings you God's Word. We trust that you will be blessed as you listen.
The sacrifice that speaks. The sacrifice that speaks. Hebrews 11 verse 4 and then Acts chapter 10. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and by it he being dead, yet speaketh. Abel offered such a sacrifice that though he was dead, the Bible says he was speaking. We find another example in Acts chapter 10 of a man whose sacrifice spoke to God. Acts 10 verse 1, and there was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian band, a devout man and one that feared God with all his house, which gave much alms to the people and prayed to God always. He saw in a vision, evidently, about the ninth hour of the day, an angel of God coming to him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, What is it, Lord? And he said unto him, Thy prayers and thine alms are come up before God for a memorial before God. Psalm 115, verse 12. The Lord has been mindful of us. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of Aaron. Sacrifices that speak are memorials that cause God to set up divine appointments for you. Sacrifices that speak are memorials that cause God to set up divine appointments for you. In the passage we read about Cornelius, the man was minding his own business. He was just worshiping the Lord, giving to people, praying, fasting. And the Bible says to us that these activities of his had come before God as a memorial. That means like concrete before God. God couldn't miss it. Even though he was not physically in heaven, the sacrifices made their way to heaven, and God himself had to pay attention. I want to say there are certain things that get the attention of God. When you begin to do it from your heart, nobody made Cornelius to do it. He just did it from his heart. And this was a Gentile under another dispensation. He was not even a child of God. He was not even born again. He did not belong to the commonwealth of Israel. He did not have the blood of Jesus on him. But because he did it from his heart, God said, it got my attention. Cain killed Abel, but Abel was dead. But by that sacrifice, he was speaking. I want to say in this hour, God will call to remembrance the things you have done. The Lord will remember you in the day of trouble. He will remember your sacrifices and your burnt offerings. These are the days not to draw back. These are the days to serve God with a pureness of heart. These are the days to pursue God. These are the days to go after God. You either go deeper or you go crazy. This is the day to dwell in the Word of God more than you have ever done. It's a day to go deeper into the Lord. Go deeper and take the extra mile and stretch yourself. I want to say to you, the God that sees in secret is about to reward somebody in the open. I want to say your sacrifices will stand before God in this hour, and they will speak for you in this hour. I want to say God will bring to remembrance, just like he remembered Mordecai. I want to say to somebody this morning, under the sound of my voice, that a memorial is standing before God for your children. A memorial is standing before God for your business. A memorial is standing before God for all the things you've been through, because you kept going forward. Like Cornelius, you did it when it was not convenient. Like Abel, you recognized that you needed God. You gave him your best. You gave him your first. There's a day of honor, and that day of honor is not behind you. That day of honor is in front of you. Is there a witness in the house of the Lord this morning? Hallelujah. The sacrifice that speaks. He was dead, but yet he was still speaking. You see, Cornelius could not, in his wildest imagination, have arranged an apostolic visit for himself. There are some things you look at right now, you don't even know how they can ever happen. Maybe you need to see the MD of the company. Maybe you need to see the highest person in that department. You don't know how you will make that connection. Cornelius did not know either. He just focused on God, and God focused on his problem. Hallelujah to Jesus. You see, when you make him first in your life, you will never take last. Oh my God. I said, when you make him first in your life, you will never take last. You see, our life is like the wheel of a bicycle. God must be the center. He must be the hub of that thing. Every other activity should go into the hub, the center of that thing. When God becomes the hub of your life, I want to tell you, he will set up divine appointments for you. There's no way a Gentile unbeliever could have been able to call a Jewish apostle. It's not possible. But God went and met Peter. I want to say, God will meet the obstacle in your life and talk to them. I said, God will meet the obstacle in your life and talk to them. You know, when Jacob was having that situation in his life and the father-in-law was chasing him, he was going to harm him. He said, the God of my father appeared to you and rebuked you last night. There are certain things that will cause God to arise and rebuke your enemy. God went ahead of him and said, listen, Peter, there's a gentleman you must meet. When God sets up an appointment, you cannot say you are not seeing me. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? When God sets up an appointment, they cannot say they don't want to see you. For some reason, they will hold that place for you. For some reason, they will keep that job for you, because God will supernaturally speak to that situation. In the time of famine, you shall laugh, because heaven will set up supernatural appointment. I want to declare over somebody that this month we are in, divine appointment will be set up for you by God. God will speak to your mountain. God will declare to your mountain. God will declare to your obstacle. That is a child of God. You must see him. You have waited enough in your power. But I want to say, the God of divine appointment is about to give you a visitation. He's about to give you a visitation. He's about to give you a lifting. He will speak to that mountain. He will speak to that obstacle. And they must listen to me. They must listen to you. They must look for you. The job will look for you. The appointment will look for you. I said, the appointment will look for you. The job will look for you. Is there a witness in the house of the Lord today? Please sit down for a bit. You know what happened? He needed God. God sent and said, go and look for that person. I don't know who I'm speaking to by the spirit of prophecy, but go and write it down. They will call you. Amen. Somebody called me from Adamawa. Was it on Friday? He said, Pastor, my pastor gave me your number that I must share this testimony. He said, we came for men's convention that year, and you told us, before you leave, let me pray for you. Some of you may remember those guys, about three or four of them. He said, you prophesied on me that if God is going to give me a house, and that if I was living in one bedroom, it would be two bedrooms. And if I was living in two bedroom, it would be three bedroom. He said, honestly, Gaskia, we didn't know how that would ever happen. But suddenly, his father died. And they left, is it two houses? Family shared one, and the whole family gathered together. He said, those people cannot give you anything. But unanimously, they voted. And they said, that house only belongs to you. He said, Daddy, I'm in that house now. I want to say, the word of the Lord will not fall to the ground for you. Simple obedience can bring big manifestations. Big doors, they swing on small hinges. All you need to do it from your heart. Obey God. What did the widow of Zarephath do? What did the widow of Zarephath do? Give the prophet food. She could have eaten it. We are living in a day that you must hear God. Whatever he says to do, do it. And she had enough supply for the famine. There shall be enough in your house, my brother. Another pastor came to me this last week also. He said, we want you to come back to our church to preach again. I said, why? He said, well, the last time you were there, you prophesied on one couple. He said, God will give you a baby boy. They didn't have children. He said, but anyway, when they took in, the scan said it was a baby girl. And they came and met him. That man of God said it was a baby boy, but scan says it's a baby girl. He said, well, man of God said so. He said, when the baby came out, the baby was a boy. I want to say to you, the word of the Lord will not fall to the ground where you are concerned. Is there an amen in the house? He said, another guy was being chased out from his house for rent of 100,000. When you came to our church, you didn't know, but you prophesied over the guy that he will build house. He has brought that one to me. He said, well, but pastor, do you realize? He said, the man built the house, he has moved inside. He said, the third man, you told him to plant a seed. He refused to plant seed, he went down. You will plant seed of righteousness that will give you a lifting. There are seeds, there are sacrifices that speak. But it must be God telling you. But once he's told you, just do it. A farmer who is not eating anything now is because he didn't put anything in the ground. When God says, plant that seed, don't listen to all these funny people. Just obey God, because it will come to your, back to your family and it will bless you. I don't like giving personal testimonies of my own. You won't even believe some of it. They'll blow you. But you need to obey God. You need to obey God. I say you need to obey God. Cornelius just kept doing, kept blessing. Then God said, this orphan, Cornelius. This widow, Cornelius. This one, Cornelius. That one. Now only in there. But people will not know what you are doing in secret. But God will reward you in the open. If you believe God will reward you in the open, can you give him a wave offering this morning? Don't tell God you are too busy for him. Oh. Don't tell God you don't have time. You don't have time to pray. You don't have time to worship. You don't have time to sacrifice. You don't have time to do nothing. Faith that says nothing and does nothing receives nothing. Sacrifices that speak will cause God to prophesy your destiny. A very good example is Genesis 22. You can write it down from verse 10 to verse 18. Remember what happened there. God told Abraham to take his only son, and he did. And then in verse 10, he stretched forth his hand to kill the boy. And the angel said to him, don't do it. I know you will not withhold your son from me, and you fear me, and so on. And he lifted his eyes. There was a ram caught in a thicket. And then verse 14, in fact, verse 15. And the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time. The first time was, don't kill your son. You are a good man. You are a faithful man. But the second time, you see, God did not only provide for the now. He always goes beyond the now. He's a God of the overflow. The widow came and said, I have just little oil in my house. He said, borrow vessel, not a few. Pay your bill and live on the others. The corn, the wine, the oil. God will always do for you more than just maintenance. He will give you not only corn, he will give you wine. On top of the wine, he will give you oil. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Even in dangerous times, he said, in time of famine you shall laugh. Your God is bigger than the famine. Your supply is not coming from the earth, it's coming from heaven, and it's unlimited supply. Is there an amen somewhere in the house of God? He said, by myself, verse 16, have I sworn, said the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, and in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven and as the sand which is upon the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies, and in thy seed shall all the nations. Somebody say all. One more time. One more time. Be blessed because thou hast what? Obeyed my voice. Hallelujah. What's the story here? The man obeyed God. He gave his best. He gave his first. He honored the Lord. I'm talking about your time, your talent, your resources, your devotion. Hallelujah. Let me take a side journey. Some of you, the amount of movies you watch, if you give God one tenth of that time, you'll be more spiritual than you are. You even have more money than you have. Because Holy Spirit starts speaking to you. I didn't say don't watch movies. I say some of it is just too much. Even if somebody dies in the movie, you start crying because you are meditating on it too much. You watch, hey, this person has died. Oh, it's just a movie. If movie can move you to that point, let the word of God to move you to that point. Hallelujah to Jesus. The man gave his best. God said, hey, okay, don't kill your son. I've provided. But on Mount Moriah, God began to prophesy Mount Calvary. He began to say, hey, your destiny is big. I'm going to do through you, all the nations of the earth will be blessed. Through Cornelius, what happened? We, the Gentiles, the gospel was open to us. I want to say your obedience to God in this season, you're putting God first in this season, is not only going to bless you, it's going to be a blessing to your family. It's going to be a blessing to your children. It's going to be a blessing to your children's children. Some of us are here today because of the obedience of our parents. Amen? Obedience of our parents. My grandfather got saved from idol worship. Hallelujah. Then he took my father to church. Then my father took me to church. Hallelujah. And the thing goes down. They say, should come and be up. I said, no, he's born again. You know, go worship idol again. Hallelujah to Jesus. Amen. The obedience of one person can affect an entire generation. Your life will count. I say your life will count. See how you are looking at me. Your life will count for your family. Many times God just goes to a family and picks one person. And through your prayers, people are coming to Jesus. You are doing very well. You are good. When you get to heaven, you see the crowd that will be in your house. You say, how did I do? You say, you witnessed to this one witnessed to this one. Hallelujah. Make him the first. Make him the first. And God began to prophesy the destiny of Abraham and his seed. I want to say to you, God is looking beyond you. He's looking to tomorrow. Many of us are worried about this nation. Oh God, what is going to happen? He said, eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. What I have prepared for those that love me. Because you are here, he said, I will give men for you and people for your life. Just because you are here, even if Turiyake Bongo, that means if your back is against the wall and everything seems like shutting down, because you are precious to God, he will intervene, he will get into the fiery furnace, he will turn it around because his children are here and we are precious to him. I want to announce to you on your account, just like in the case of Paul, 276 people were saved aboard that ship. I want to announce to children of God this morning, because you are here in this nation, Nigeria shall be delivered. Nigeria shall be saved. God will give men if necessary for you. I say God will give men if necessary for you. I want to declare your children will not be consumed. Your wives will not be consumed. Your husbands will not be consumed. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I decree and I declare today, it is well with this church. It is well with your family. You are going from strength to strength. And there's plenty of resources, plenty of finances to get the job done and live a good life. Give an amen in the house of the Lord today. Let's take another thought quickly. Or two. If we don't finish it, we do it another time. Sacrifices that speak will cause you to hear the secrets in God's heart and reverse judgment. Sacrifices that speak. All right, Genesis chapter 8, from verse 20 to 21. Sacrifices that speak will cause you to hear the secret in God's heart and reverse judgment. I have two examples. Remember the story of Hannah? Peninnah had been making her life a living hell. Please, when somebody is having problems, if you cannot help them, don't make them miserable. Don't make them miserable. You got engaged. The other sister did not get anybody yet. Every time you see her, you'll be doing engagement ring like this, so that her head will spark. See my ring. How about sister? Have mercy now. We two go marry. Abio. Eh? God bless you with that full loaded car. Every time you must remind us, our own is coming. Hallelujah. You got twins. You must remind us. Anyway, Peninnah was such a woman. She made this woman miserable. I'm sure they were singing in the tap, in the kitchen. Hannah, you may be beautiful. You may be yellow like yellow banana, or black, brown like sugar, or whatever. You're not born. Crazy people. She was so touched in her heart that when she went to Shiloh, she was ready to give herself, if necessary, for that miracle. You know, there's some needs in your life that say, Father, whatever it takes. But you know what? Jesus has given everything already for you. It's your faith and obedience that God needs. But when you come to a place of surrender like that, you can pick divine signals. Somehow, nobody told her. Even the way she prayed, we've never seen it in the Bible before. Nobody told Hannah to be, how can you be telling God? God, you have a need in your life. It's like telling your teacher, teacher, there are some things you don't know. Even if your teacher doesn't know, you keep quiet. If you don't want to fail that exam. This woman went and met God, said, God, I have a need. You have a need. God said, what's wrong with this girl? Because at that point, he said, Father, if there's anything hindering me here, just remove it. Do you know God really had a need? Eli and his sons had backslidden. They'd been stealing offering and sleeping with women in the temple. God was trying to replace them. Some Hannah just picked it up in the spirit. She was on a spiritual frequency that could pick it up. I said, God, if you give me this boy, I'll give him back to you. God said, me, I'm God. You are telling me you will give me something. God now moved the high priest. Said, go. That woman is talking. No? She's speaking language. She's speaking on a serious frequency. And the high priest God, I said, you, this drunk woman, how long will you be drunk? Most of us will have missed our miracle at that point. I'll be people in the gallery. We will have missed our miracle. Say, how can the high priest be talking to me like that? I mean, how do you know who I am? I'm the wife of Elkanah. Even though I don't have this, you don't have. Sometimes God will test you to see what's in your heart. The woman said, high priest, you will not stop my miracle, far. I forgive you for the false accusation. I'm not drunk. It's sorrow of heart. Then the same high priest that was rebuking her for being a child of Belial changed his mouth. And the miracle came out of the high priest's mouth and said, by this time, I do know God honored her. I want to say something to you. When you do it from your heart, you begin to find God's secrets. When Noah, let's read this Noah bit. When the flood finished, let's read this one. When the flood finished, and Noah, Genesis 8:20, builded an altar unto the Lord and took of every clean beast and of every clean fowl and offered burnt offerings on the altar, verse 21, and the Lord smelled a sweet savour, and the Lord said in his heart, somebody said the Lord said in his heart, I will not again curse the ground anymore for man's sake, for the imagination of man's heart is evil from his youth, neither will I again smite anymore every living thing as I have done. How many of you remember the lockdown? When they say we should not come out. When you came out the first time, where did you go? Is it not to look for food? Some people went to look for toilet paper. Some people went to look for garri in the market, tomato. People were. But Noah had been in a lockdown for a long time. You know, his own lockdown was worse than our own. His own lockdown, rain was falling, houses were sinking, cows were dying, people were dying, they were floating around him, and he was locked down. He couldn't come out of the boat. And the thing was, have you been on a big boat where there's on the high sea? It is getting used to. I've traveled on the high sea in some countries. You'll be praying for you to see ground. You just be praying that let the thing, because when you look here, you see water. You cannot see the end. You look back, you see water. You see water. And you are from Kaduna where we don't have sea. You'll be praying for yourself. Say, who sent me? Who sent me? Here am I, Lord, send me. Now I see him, they send you. You be seeing water. You just be saying, let them just touch ground. Even if you're inside the plane. I was flying one time from Leeds. I was going to Paris. And the plane could not land because of water. See water, runway full. People began to pray. Even people that say there's no God were calling him. So I'm imagining Noah in this very horrible situation. Eventually the thing dry. What's the first thing to do? Noah built an altar. He was saying, God, if not for you, my eyes see where I would have died. I saw my neighbors floating in the water. When he did that, he didn't cater to his flesh. He catered to his spirit. See, when people go through hard times, most of the time they want to, you know, go and do something in the natural. He honored God. And God smelled. It was a sacrifice for him. I don't know what you want to do after a lockdown. Maybe you want to, you know, some people want to go and get drunk. First thing this guy did was, and the Bible said, when God smelled it, God said in his heart, that sacrifice made God to talk. I pray that what you do for God will make him to talk. I pray that your devotion will make him to talk. I pray that when he begins to talk, he will begin to reverse judgment where you are concerned. God said, I will never do it again. If man can go through this and still remain true. Some of you have been through some things and the devil will say, with all your serving God, look at how long it has taken. With all your serving God, look at how long you have taken. You have been in a lockdown mode. Nothing has been working for you. But if you will still sacrifice, if you will still worship, if you will still give your time, if you will still give your talent, if you still give your resources, in spite of what you are hearing from the devil, God will smell a good savour from you and begin to reverse judgment and begin to give you a new season. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Finally, one more sacrifice that speaks. The blood sacrifice of Jesus speaks of redemption and Passover. Somebody say with me, the blood sacrifice of Jesus speaks of redemption and Passover. Hebrews reminds us, he said, the blood of sprinkling that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. As I close this morning, I want to remind you again that Jesus is the highest sacrifice possible because he is God and his blood came from God. That when that sacrifice was made in my behalf and in your behalf, there was no altar on the earth that was fit to take that blood. There was no altar in the atmospheric heaven that was fit to take that blood. There was no altar in the stellar heavens. That is where the galaxies and all these things, celestial bodies are, to take that blood. The only altar that could take the blood of Jesus in your behalf was the mercy seat in heaven. Just as Abel's sacrifice was speaking to God, I want to say the sacrifice of Jesus on the mercy seat 24/7. Is speaking your name this morning. In this season we are in, child of God, you need to add your voice to what the blood is saying. The blood is saying to you this morning, you are justified, just as if you have never sinned. The blood is saying to you this morning that is the blood of Passover, kidnapping, rape, murder, accident, destruction, poverty. The blood is saying, I have paid for you, I have paid for your children. And I want to say, every demon spirit, they can hear the voice of the blood. It's about time you added your voice this morning and begin to declare with your own mouth what the blood of Jesus is speaking over you. I want to say to you this morning, as you go this week, the blood testifies concerning you, and you yourself testify concerning yourself that I am far from destruction. I am far from, oh somebody, I'm far from kidnapping. I'm far from every evil flying around, because there's a blood on the mercy seat in heaven calling my name. I declare over you and your family that evil will pass over, terror will pass over, poverty will pass over. Everything that Satan is selling in this hour, they cannot land, because the blood of Jesus is upon you and upon your family. Lift your hand if you receive that. Stand to your feet everywhere and give him praise if you believe what I just said, that that blood is speaking for you and yours, and it's well with you this week. I said it's well with you this week. As you travel, the blood will go ahead of you. As you return, the blood will go ahead of you. In your place of abode, the blood will be there. In your place of business, the blood will be there. Wherever your children are, the blood will be there. I declare over you this morning, none of us shall be missing. The blood will speak for us by day. The blood will speak for us by night. It is well with you in your habitation. That there's a kind of presence of God around your home. The blood is speaking for you. Lift your hand and give him glory this morning.
Thank you for listening to today's message. Do join us same time next week. Follow us on our social media handles, Facebook and Instagram at Restoration Ministries International, Twitter and Mixler at RBCM Online, and our website is www.rbcmonline.org. You can also be part of our live power pack services every Wednesday by 5:30 p.m. and on Sunday by 7 a.m. and 8:30 a.m. respectively, at Restoration International Conference Center, RICC, Rome New Extension, Kaduna South. God bless you.